Welcome, Lone Star Sock and Sumo. Today we will be joining Justin in Japan when he talks to Takeshi, his senpai, and we will be discussing a lot of issues there. But I want to go through real quick about American Sumo that has been happening. Beer City Sumo Open happened not too long ago. You can go watch that Grand Sumo Breakdown. There was a lot of great matches. I saw the lightweight and the middleweight were fantastic because they were won both by lightweights. The first and second in lightweight was Ebido and second was Gabe Unick, and they did the same thing. They moved up a weight class to get that middle. That was awesome. Darius Campbell in heavyweight went undefeated both in heavy and open to get 2 golds. They also have a day 2, which is really fun. They had no novice. They had team tournaments. You can watch all of this in Grand Sumo Breakdown on YouTube. Big fun. Go watch that as soon as you can. There was also the Mr. All-American, Dan Sumo's Mr. All-American Sumo tournament. And I didn't get to see that one. I don't think it was done live. But we have Mr. Alabama, Andrew Roden himself, getting first place in that tournament. Second, again, Edibo, who just seems to be traveling around kicking as much butt as possible. And a Zachary Johnson Dunlop got third. I don't really know that guy. I kind of would like to find out about him because I know that I think Kyle was there. And if Kyle didn't get in the top three, that's something I want to watch. But go check those out if you can. And now go see. We'll start off with some little footage and photos of Justin's trip to Japan. And then we'll go into the credits, the beginning opening credits. And then we'll have a conversation with Takeshi. See you later. Welcome to Lone Star Sake and Sumo. I'm Caleb, and not even close near me is Justin Gizzard right now.
On the other side of the world is Justin and the great Mr. Takeshi.
This is the first time I'm actually getting to meet Takeshi. I've been following him. I've been watching his stuff on USA Sumo for years, but haven't actually got to ever meet him. Not to mention, I've been wrestling Justin for years, and he praises him all the time.
Yeah.
So this is awesome.
The reason I do sumo.
If you don't notice, I am here still in Texas. It's nighttime. I just got off of work. It is morning time in Japan over there where Justin is.
We're here in Kyoto City.
Yes.
How's it going? Saying hi to all the local peoples. I guess we're here at it's like this cute cafe that everybody has like toy dogs, like tiny dogs.
Like, yeah. Like the kinds like rich white ladies carrying purses and stuff?
Yeah, but it's rich Kyoto Japanese.
Oh.
Yeah. It's interesting. But the food is good.
Yeah, food was good.
Well, food is the most important part. That is true. Trust me. Trust me. That is true. Okay. I've been really excited about this because I wanted to ask Takeshi about his YouTube channel, is specifically the membership thing where he teaches sumo and has
Yeah.
subtitles. It is fantastic. I've been watching sumo since the early 90s, and yet the way you describe things is simplistic to where I can understand it. And I wanted you to talk a little bit about that, sir.
I'm sorry. Good job,
Thank
sir.
you.
Okay, so on your channel, what made you think of the idea of teaching sumo via YouTube?
You may know, but I used to live in Los Angeles and do sumo with Justin and many other American people. And I have a lot of sumo experience in Japan, the US. And I just realized I can, help them to improve sumo skill. So now I live in Japan, and in this situation, not many, foreigner come to Japan.
Right, with COVID.
Especially with that, yeah.
So, but on YouTube or on the internet, everyone can see it, and I can support them to, do similar. Na-na-na. Yeah, that's why I started YouTube,
I
and.
really like the fact that you put the bullet points at the end of each instruction. That's really helpful. I like pause it and I write stuff down in my little notebook every time.
For beginners, that does help a lot, having the visual, like a bullet points, point by point.
That's true.
Yeah, excellent. I know I'm a member. I'm pretty sure Justin's a member as well.
Yes.
Thank you, thank you.
I probably can put the description down, the link down in the description. Trust me, it's like only 10 bucks a month, and it's worth it if you really
Well,
want to learn
all of you guys who are starting, starting sumo, even, like my students or Caleb's students or the people who we teach in class, but Takeshi, like his videos really, really go into detail, point by point. I mean, I watch sometimes before class just so I can, I can show
Same.
students. So it's worth watching. And even for people who have done sumo for a long time, it's worth watching that again. Going over a lot of the basics, and then like otsuke or just even like a maimitsu grip,
Yeah, I was going to go into
and
that.
knowing the difference between like an inside, like your inside grip and your outside grip, like a what was it, hidari
Uate, shitate,
uate, shitate, and
nigi otsu, hidari
negi
otsu.
otsu, hidari
I
otsu.
liked when you broke down the styles, the four main styles. That was really well done. Most people only think of the main two, Oshi and Yotsu, and you broke down four, and I liked the way you did that. It was very good. You've been doing sumo for a long time, and what I like to ask anyone who's done sumo for a long time, do you have any rivalries or matches that you always look fondly on, people you enjoy going up against, and matches that you always get excited about when you think back
Like
on
a
them?
fight or in pro sumo or something.
So now in pro sumo, there are many people I used to wrestle with, like Tobizaru is
Oh,
my one of
he's so
my
good.
teammates in my university. And also Mitakeumi, Hokuto Fuji, Ura, we are same age, and then we fight so many times in like a student when we were student. So I like to, of course I like to watch their matches, of course. And I just too many people.
To think about. I have a question. I do have a question for you though. How do you, for like a Tobizaru, how do you think his sumo has grown? Like, has it gotten better since university? And because he just recently beat Terunofuji Fuji on day two in this basho. I personally, we talked about this, but I really like his strategy. Not going inside right away, and just
Be that patient.
parrying and like a jousting, and until he sees an opening, boom, boom, and then closing the gap. I really like that he's doing this now. He's not just going in or like going straight in chest to chest.
Right.
It's just like, so I don't know. What do you think about his sumo?
Actually, that is his style since when he was a small student.
Oh, really?
So he just not only just attack, sometimes back, and you know, do many, like, I don't know how to say it, but this kind of stuff. And when he was a university, he was just right about like 100 kilograms, which is 220 pounds.
Whoa.
So he was very lightweight.
Okay.
Even, you know, 100 in small world, it's a lightweight, right?
So he fights like a lightweight.
Yeah. Mm. But now he's getting bigger and he has more like strength, power.
Yeah.
And just, you know, his style was so strong because no one can do it. And now he added the power with this
and
kind
the weight.
Yes. So,
sorry. Yeah, there's a lot of little dogs. I don't know if you hear that.
It's all right.
It's a cute dog place.
And the one thing he told me before is, so in this COVID situation, especially like pro small wrestlers, they couldn't allow to go out like any restaurant or I don't know, go outside.
Yeah.
They cannot do it.
Yeah.
So they had to focus on their sumo. So Tobizaru said he used to go outside a lot.
Yeah.
But he couldn't. He focused on sumo so much for these years, you know.
And you can tell he's gotten better.
Yeah. Yeah. I love how his patience now. Like I said, like he used to always like hit and keep going, but he would never like wait for that opportunity. He just tried to create it. And now he like is good at waiting for that opening to hit and attack.
Timing. Yeah.
Oh man, yeah, that's awesome. I enjoyed that. Anybody in amateur sumo when you were here in America that you enjoyed wrestling against?
Like a US Open. Anybody do you think is talented?
Actually, I was kind of surprised the last time. Before this year, last time I, you know, competed in US Open is 2019, yeah. 3 years ago.
Yeah. That was my last one. I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah, everyone's getting so better. I mean, improved.
Mm.
Good touch eye and like any techniques.
American sumo.
Yeah.
It actually leads me into
we're growing. We're growing, you know.
Yeah.
It grew even more during somehow it grew more during COVID.
Because people didn't have time to do stuff, so they were searching for things online and they found sumo online.
Yeah,
I don't know.
But that leads me into my next question, which was since you were in American sumo years ago and you recently seen more now when you did the US Open recently, how you felt about the growth of American sumo?
This is a tough question.
Sorry.
Very deep question.
Yeah.
Just kinda, if you want to like compare it to, it's not very comparable, but like to your amateur sumo in Japan, like we're not even close, but like, what are some of the differences you see?
But I feel like adjusting, American people has more like energy to not only improve sumo, but also like spread the sumo world.
Yeah.
So I feel like more energy from American people actually. So in Japan, the sumo amateur sumo like system is already like made it
kind of set.
Yeah. We just follow the rule, and you know,
it's true.
Go middle school, high school, and we can only focus on just our small style stuff. But in like United States, everyone is trying to get sumo is bigger, and I love it.
Yeah.
we're getting really excited about it, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, that is the biggest difference. Like in America, where, you know, we're kind of, I guess, you know, guys like me and you and stuff, we're like pioneers, like kind of, or and trying to, you know, trying to get Americans to even understand and know that sumo is outside of Japan, you know, and trying to get people to understand that men and women can do sumo and different sizes, because everybody has one idea of sumo and they think to do sumo you have to be, you know, 400 pounds or, you know, and like big and tall and I guess that is the fun part about growing sumo in the US, because you get different types of people from different backgrounds. Some people do wrestling, some people never do anything, and somehow they just start to be, they get obsessed with sumo and they become really good.
Yeah.
The wrestling guys like a Jordan Karst, Andrew Roden, Edobo,
Eric.
Like Eric. Yep.
Yeah.
So it's kind of cool to see the evolution of people coming from different backgrounds. There's jiu-jitsu guys that are starting to do sumo now. Yeah. I don't think jiu-jitsu really translates too much, but you know, there's judo guys that come in, and there's football guys, American football guys.
Like Jordan Sykes and Mark Jones from Florida. Yeah. You got a lot of Texas guys. This is true.
It's pretty exciting because, you know, we're evolving like our own style, I guess, in a way.
Yeah. That's good too.
Okay, so this is a question that I wasn't sure about, but I really wanted to ask it from someone from Japan who loves sumo. We get a lot of reports, we have for the last decade, of, the best way I can describe it is sumo in Japan dropping in popularity. The way baseball is in America right now. Like, there's a lot less kids doing baseball in America. And there's a lot less kids doing, like in junior high and high school, doing sumo in Japan, and they have less people trying out for professionals. Do you feel that's true, first of all? And secondly, do you think it's something that Japan needs to work on? Or do you think they should just change things up somehow? I know it's a difficult question, sorry.
So, for first question, yes, it's true. I mean, Japanese population is getting, you know, smaller.
Oh, that's a good point. That's a good point.
It's not only sumo. Any sports has the same problem. Like baseball, maybe soccer, football is popular still. Yeah, but not many kids do sumo recently. And so many sumo club in Japan have same problem. They don't have they have a dojo, they have a teacher, but they don't have kids.
Wow.
The kids.
It's opposite in the US.
Yeah.
We have a teacher. We got the students.
We don't have a place to wrestle.
we wish we had an indoor dojo. Mm-hmm. Jesus.
Yeah.
That would be a dream.
Yeah. That caused a different problem too. So dojo needs a maintain, right?
Yeah, right.
But there's no kids, no keiko, no one cares about dojo, and the dojo is gonna be, you know, like bones.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that is
like an old baseball field.
Yeah. You see more and more of those in America, like abandoned ones where grass is growing high and the fences are rusting over. It makes me sad, but I don't know what to do. I mean, baseball is just not what it used to be popularity wise in America.
Baseball very, very popular here.
Oh yeah.
yeah. That's the thing. We get a lot of, when you look at professional baseball, like a lot of Central Americans and Japanese guys are becoming stars. It's not as many Americans as it used to be. So it's just an odd thing. And like in sumo, a lot of the big names in sumo are now Mongolian, and there are some Europeans, but
Oh yeah.
It's just what it is. It's just what it
Well, we just have to wait for Asanoyama
is.
to become Yokozuna. So next year,
Takeshi.
Yeah.
he loves Takakesho.
Oh
I'm
yeah.
a big like a Asanoyama fan, but obviously recently Asanoyama had to
Yeah.
he got punished.
Yeah.
But the rivalry will come back. Takakesho versus Asanoyama next
Yeah, we're
year.
gonna have to talk about that. He lost to someone in the third division, Asayama. Yeah, he
He
went 6-1.
barely lost.
It doesn't
He
matter, man.
barely.
Like,
It was a little slight drop.
That's true.
We'll talk about that later, you and me. We'll go at it.
And that's a problem too. There is no like a big famous star in Prosmo now. Yeah, Hakuho was retired. Now, of course, Tel No Fuji is a Yokozuna. But
Not really
yeah,
a
it's not
that
like
kind of
no, you know, not.
star power.
He had a run for a little bit where he had like three or four in a year, but then like his knees caught up with him and he's still really good. It's still amazing how good he is considering he's on such bad knees, but yeah, it's not the same.
Is
It's
gonna
not the same.
be a problem.
Right.
But I think guys like Wakatakage, maybe Hoshoryu, they're kind of the new stars. They're
Young
not
Bucks?
enough, but
Yeah. They're already famous, but only for, people know about sumo.
There's no,
Other people don't know about.
That's true. Like, there's people who don't even, there's like Japanese people who don't even watch sumo, but they know who Hakuho is.
And
They
also
know
show you.
Asashoryu, they know Chunofuji,
Takanohana.
Takanohana.
Yeah, we need people like that because, like, the Hawaiians made it big for, like, there's a lot of people in America who know who Akebono and Konishiki are, even though they know nothing about sumo. We don't have any of those guys that cross the I'm a sumo fan line. There's people who do that in all sports, and I feel like no one, you're right, no one in sumo does that at the moment. They cross the I like sumo. Yeah.
Oh, so with that said, who do you think has potential of becoming a star? Who's kind of getting there, like in your mind? They could be in Juryo, they could be in the top level.
Well,
Like who excites you?
So in yeah, I could say Hoshoryu, probably.
Yay! We got a Hoshoryu
But
fan.
I really hate to say that, but he's from Mongolia, right?
Who's the next Japanese star?
Most of sumo fan is all Japanese people, and they want to
They want to see a Japanese.
Japanese, Yokozuna.
Understandable.
Yeah.
I honestly think Wakatakage
So,
may be their best choice, but I still think it's going to be Ozeki, but I think he's going to be the best Japanese wrestler.
He has a potential to be a Ozeki, but Yokozuna, I'm not sure. Yokozuna is just incredible, and then, I couldn't understand. But now there is a one like very strong guy in university. He's in World Games. Daiki Nakamura.
Daiki. There were
Who?
two.
I'm sorry, who?
You met Daiki at the World Games.
Was he the really big guy, or he's the guy who wants to do football?
Big guy, big
Big
guy.
guy. The
He
other guy,
was incredible to watch. He was. Both of them were. I kind of wish the guy who wants to do football would just go do sumo, even though I love American football. But oh my God, because he played mind games with the big dude. He, like, they were facing off for the heavyweight in the USA Games, and he like backed up, and you saw the big dude that you were talking about. They could just go, oh, okay, what do I do? He backed up. I can't just charge out at him at full speed and messed him up, and he lost.
What was
But he
his
came back and
name?
won open, so they were both incredible.
Hidetora Hanada.
Hanada?
Yeah,
Oh,
Hanada,
yeah, Hanada.
They these two are extremely, you know, strong and has super potential. But, you know, of course, Canada retire, sumo, yeah, and go to American football. Yeah, I understand that. I suppose his choice. But Daiki Nakamura, he's continue sumo. And I think maybe next January,
mm-hmm,
or May, March, he's gonna go into the pro sumo.
Yay! What, yeah, would he come in at? What, like a sandame?
No, Makushita 10. Makushita 10.
Oh, really? Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Oh, so he could jump.
Yeah.
If he does well, he can actually jump pretty fast.
And his coach saying that he already has a, like a Makuchi power, like a Makuchi strong.
He had flexibility too. His legs and hips were wide, and when I was watching him, it was very impressive to watch that guy wrestle. It really was.
He still has a, like, more, you know, like, how do I say, space to grow.
Yeah.
He was the one that I was really excited about. I was talking to people like, this guy is fantastic. When I was watching him,
all you sumo fans, watch the World Games.
And there's one more guy.
Oh.
My high school. He's 19. He just graduated our high school from this March. And he was a high school champion.
Okay.
And 2 years in a row. And everyone expects he entered pro sumo, but he didn't from after his he graduated his high school. But now he last month he competed like a big tournament.
Okay.
And he won that tournament, and now he has a Makushita 15. The right to enter from Makushita 15.
Okay.
His
name is Ochiai.
Ochiai.
Yeah.
We won't know his, you have to let me know what, like, his I guess ring name is.
Yeah.
When he joins.
He said he's going to go enter pro sumo from next January basho from Makushita. Right?
January 2023.
Yeah. 2023, yeah.
Oh shit.
Against some new people. Great.
Oh. Sorry, there's a lot of bugs out here.
There are three strong kids. One is retired and going to American football.
Yeah.
And then we still have two.
All right.
Okay. But yeah.
Adjustable.
Then next year can be fun.
It could be. Well, like we said, we've seen that one. We met him. He's really good.
Mm-hmm.
I actually really hope the other guy makes it in pro football. We haven't had a foreigner really become a star in pro football yet. We've had a few of them make it, but none of them might be a star, and I think he could be.
Have we ever had like a Japanese football?
No.
Japanese American, but not Japanese, no.
No, and then
that would be cool.
That would be really awesome, especially because, yeah, they're big on it. Mostly it's been Canadians and Australians who have made it.
And then like for like offensive linemen or defense, like, what's that, like a New Zealanders or not New Zealand, Samoan.
Samoans, yes. Well, I think of them as Americans, but yes, they do make it pretty big. And not just that one of the best safeties of all time was a Samoan, Troy Polamalu. But a Japanese guy, that would become a big thing. It was like when I was a kid and a few of them made in baseball. And then Ichiro showed up. It's a big thing when it happens, especially on the West Coast. It's huge.
Yeah.
And for somebody with sumo experience, I'm very curious how that's going to translate for football.
Me too. Because there are a lot of similarities. The footwork is different, but like all the upper body stuff and where the strength needs to be is all the same. So I think it could work out really well. Awesome. Justin, you got any more questions? This is a fun thing. All right, Takeshi, I hope you come down to Texas sometime and join us in one of our tournaments or practices and stuff.
Oh. Maybe you want to tell them?
So, later of November, which is next year, no, next month, I'm gonna go visit the US again and stay maybe less than a month.
Okay.
Probably I will visit Texas. I mean, I really want.
We really want to. We love it. We love doing sumo with people.
Gotta have a day, Eiko.
Sure, yeah.
We have our last tournament in November, too. That would be awesome if he shows up for that one. One Houston.
Hold on, the Houston tournament.
Yeah, Texas Sumo Open. That would be freaking awesome.
November 2nd.
Anyway, it was fantastic meeting you, sir. I had a really good time talking to you. I hope to get to meet you and talk to you some more. Justin, I can't wait till you get back. Miss you, dude.
Miss you, too.
We got more sumo to do.
I'll be down. I won't be down for practice this Tuesday, but the following Tuesday.
I don't have the points in front of me, but I passed you in the Texas State Championship. I'm number two now, dude. You guys have a wonderful time. It was great meeting you, and come back to Texas to Sake and Sumo, and we'll talk to y'all some more.
Peace.
Get your sumo on.